Hi, I'm Leila, an early architect and BIM specialist working at Autodesk. I'm regularly speaking about Open BIM and IFC on various BIM events, and I also wrote many blog posts about this topic. But still, I keep getting so many questions around Revit and IFC that I decided to try something new and launch this video series. Now, in this first video, we'll be having a look at some basic IFC concepts which you need to understand in order to be able to use IFC correctly. So let me first recap what IFC is and why I think it's often misunderstood. IFC is developed by the buildingSMART Association and it is an open standard for the BIM data exchange. IFC stands for the Industry Foundation Classes and it is not a file format, but actually a semantic schema which defines the way the building-related data is described and inherited. This also means that you can open an IFC file in a simple text editor and view its content. The foundation of IFC are, as its name already says, the classes, which can describe anything from a physical object like a wall to an abstract concept like a task. Unfortunately, the buildingSMART documentation is very complicated and even scary because it's actually meant for software developers and not for us mortal Revit users. But the good thing is that you don't need to get that deep into the theory in order to be able to use IFC correctly. Now, let's have a look how you can navigate the IFC documentation. You can always access the latest version through the buildingSMART website at technical.buildingsmart.org. As you can see here, the IFC 4 is the latest development and it's also still being updated. IFC 2x3 is also still often used, but we'll stick with IFC 4 in this video series because it is the latest development and 2x3 will become more and more obsolete in the next years. And also the IFC 4 documentation is a bit easier to navigate. The best way to find the IFC classes is to select the alphabetical listing from the main page. Since IFC 4, we can also browse the list in other languages like German or also in plain English. Keep in mind that there are a lot more IFC classes than Revit categories for two reasons. The first one is that IFC classes are often more granular, and the second one is that there are many classes which don't describe physical elements or don't have a representation in a BIM modeling software like Revit. I usually navigate the list using Ctrl F and searching for a keyword, for example, a beam. So let's have a closer look at the beam specification. After the general definition of the beam, you can also find the predefined types, which are similar to the element types in Revit and provide a more detailed specification of the beam. Another important point are the predefined property sets. All of the common property sets are mapped automatically when exporting from Revit. These are very important because they provide the most important element information in a standardized way and are always structured and named in the same way, no matter from which software the model has been exported. Same goes for the quantity sets, which are a special kind of the property sets and are used for QTO workflows. Last but not least, you can also find an exact description of how the geometry is generated for a beam. You don't need to know this in detail. It is just important to keep in mind that the way the geometry is created depends on the IFC class and also influences the behavior and the dependencies of the element, which means that the correct IFC mapping of Revit categories to IFC classes is the most important part of the export. You can find the mapping table if you go to Revit Export Settings IFC. This table displays the Revit categories matched to the IFC classes and types. Now note that this table is already filled out by default and it should cover the most common use cases, but of course you can always change it if needed. For this, you'll need to copy and paste the exact name from the IFC documentation. Keep in mind that certain Revit categories can also be excluded from the export by simply inserting not exported. This is just a starting point, as in most BIM projects, you will need a more granular mapping on the object level, which we will have a look at in a separate video. The mapping table is saved as a simple text file and can be easily shared. If you ever want to revert the default settings or if the mapping table gets messed up by switching between different languages, as it often happens to me, you can reset it very easily. Select Load, delete the default file and then hit Standard. This will regenerate the file you just deleted with the default hard-coded settings. Once we have set up the mapping table, you can launch the export dialog. Here you can select between several already predefined setups or also change these. Note that the IFC schema is always combined with a model view definition or an MVD, which defines a subset of the IFC schema. You can compare an MVD with a 3D view in Revit, where all the elements from all phases, all analytical models and calculations are all displayed at the same time. Model view definitions help to extract the data in a meaningful way, like a dedicated view of the model. This is a very simplified explanation, but I think you get the point. If you use IFC 2x3, your choice will usually be the coordination view 2.0 and for IFC 4 the reference view. These are the default MVDs defined and certified by buildingSMART for the BIM coordination. The client or the BIM manager should always define which IFC version and which MVD is to be used in a project in order to keep this consistent. Otherwise, just use the IFC 4 reference view for your specific discipline. It is important to keep in mind that Autodesk offers an open source Revit toolset and regularly updates IFC for Revit independently from Revit updates. This way, the developers can react much faster and publish updates whenever needed. For this reason, you should keep an eye on the version number and check back on apps.autodesk.com for updates. The easiest way is just to search for Revit IFC and you will be presented with the apps for the most current Revit versions. Often you will find these updates a week or two earlier on the GitHub page, where the developers are also sharing the source code, but you can also download the most current installers here. There are many ways to modify the setup, however, we will stick with the default setting for the moment and hit export. Notice that you can track the progress in the status bar on the lower left corner. With big projects, this can take a while because the whole model needs to be translated to the IFC schema. So this is usually a good opportunity to grab a coffee. It is important to review your IFC file in a viewer and not by linking or even opening it in a Revit or another BIM modeling software. When it comes to IFC viewers, there are many you can choose from. You'll find some links and recommendations in the video description. No matter which viewer you use, you will be presented with a tree structure, which will always start with the IFC project, followed by the IFC site, then the IFC building, followed by the levels defined in the project. This tree structure cannot be changed, but we can influence the naming and the properties of these elements. We will have a closer look at this in the next video. Until then, thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe.